It feels incredible. I'm just so grateful to be able to come back and have that fifth year. COVID sucked, but it did allow me to be here, so I'm just so excited to see what we can do this season.
We just heard about kind of some of the frustrations about maybe underachieving last season. How were you able to kind of use that as motivation heading into this off season and kind of trying to refine, what this group is able to accomplish?
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. We did underachieve. I think we had a lot of great players last year, and we all did very well, I'd say, individually and then also as a group as well at some points. But I think that we had a lot of unreached potential. But this year, I think we have almost a new kind of feel to the team. We're kind of using it as a fire under us. So just using it to push us this year and really come together and get that final goal of winning the championship. Yeah, I think a lot of the work comes off the field. We spend a lot of time. We have these little groups called like cat fams, and we all kind of hang out and try to do things together. So making sure that you build that connection and that friendship and trust off the field, so you're able to translate that on the field. So we make that a big thing here at UVM Lacrosse. Yeah, I'm definitely very happy that our offensive group is, for the most part, all here. It's the same people from last year. I think that we've all grown a ton, and from last year especially. We had a lot of underclassmen in that role. So giving them that year under their belt and being able to progress this year, you can just even see it in practice. Everyone's at a higher caliber. Everyone knows how to play with each other now. So I'm very excited that we're all back. And hopefully we can keep the ball on the attacking end a lot more than last year.
A road trip like this where you're playing two games in quick succession, I guess what opportunities does it present for the early season development and kind of knocking some of the rust off?
I think there's always going to be a little bit of rust and butterflies the first game. You kind of need that just to kind of calm yourself down. So I'm excited to see what we do there. I think the first quarter will probably just getting all the kinks out, but I think it will just help us grow no matter what happens. I believe we'll win, but I think it's always good to just play a little bit and see what it feels like.
What is your game plan to attack
those? Our game plan. So we have actually a lot of new plays this year, which I'm really excited about. Grace, our attacking coach, has been here for 2 years. She's an amazing coach, and she's just brought a lot of new tools to the attacking part of the game. So I'm trying to think. I don't know if I can spill any secrets, but just go hard to the goal is all I can really say right now. But I'm excited to see what we can do against them.
How much of an advantage is it to have your offensive coach be somebody you played with as your former team?
Yeah, it's really cool. It's an interesting relationship because I knew her as such an amazing teammate, and to see her grow as a coach, and she had such an incredible IQ as a player, and to see her now control our offense is just so amazing.
Coming back as a fifth year, obviously not probably the easiest decision, or maybe it was an easy decision because you love this team, but what would make this fifth year, this final year of the Catamount, successful for you?
It's already been everything I could have asked for, but I think the cherry on top would definitely be winning the championship. I think a lot of time we put a lot of pressure on us to get to that final goal, and I think that we have to focus on the games to get there first, but I think the big thing would probably be winning the American East Championship for the second time. Yeah, I've definitely thought about it a little bit. It'd be really cool to kind of get that number one spot. But my head is definitely more towards thinking like for the team and the best shooting possibility and passing to my teammates and all the above. So I've definitely thought about that, but winning as a team is definitely my highest goal. Yeah, it feels really empowering. I can't say that word for some reason. Being a woman in sports and seeing how far it's come, it's just so cool to look around and see all my teammates and being able to just be strong women that go out there and play and do what they want to do. And we also got shorts this year instead of skirts, so that was pretty awesome. I'd say that's a win, so. Yeah, I'm really proud of them. I actually, I'm in a master's program with a basketball player and a hockey player, so it's really cool to go to class every day and be like, oh my gosh, I saw you got these points, or I saw you did this, blah, blah, blah. So it's really cool being able to share that excitement with them, and hopefully we will be there with them soon. But yeah.
The wardrobe change, was that a push from the team that you guys wanted shorts versus skirts?
It was, yes. Yeah. A lot more comfortable. Thank you so much.